Good evening, everyone, and welcome back to CryptoCraft with your host, Nighthawk. I'm over here in my tree-slash-bee workshop and ready to start putting some stuff together here. So I've brought a chest full of items over. Looks like I also forgot to actually bring water, but I can go get a couple of buckets and do that pretty easy. But starting here, we got a couple of, or several carpenters, and the reason I want several of them is I want to have one that has water in it, one that has seed oil, and one that I may need. Those are the two that I need for sure, and I may need more of them as well. And I thought what I would do here is set up kind of a variety of little work areas, and I may actually build some more rooms off the side here. I have this opened up right now to get down to manage the energy cell, but once I put the remotes in, the remote monitor for that, then I'll probably close up this wall here for that little segment anyway. So carpenters need water, or they need power, and they need a liquid of some kind, and the liquid that you use depends on what you're making. So I think what we'll do is set up in this corner here our aqueous accumulator, and what we'll do is stick him in this corner. We'll put water on both sides, and I guess first thing I need to do is actually get back down to the tunnel. Let's go right here to drop back down. There we are. So this is the work tunnel. I ran power conduits all the way back from the power plant. So rather than set up separate power production, we're just all powering it up. You know, it's all powered from the same spot. Keeps things a little bit simpler that way. At least for what I'm using it for. And let's go down here and grab we'll grab a bit of iron. Perfect. And I also need to grab some copper, because I do need to make more liquiduct. And while I'm in this area, I'll grab more hardened glass and make that. Because I believe, let's see, where'd I put it? I think it's over in this chest right here. Let's grab the hardened glass and make some more liquiduct. And we do that by putting copper on either side of this hardened glass. It gives us 4 liquiduct for each one. And that should be enough liquiduct for what we're doing right now. We also need to make a couple of buckets so that we can have our water source in there. Let's drop back down into the tunnels. I might need to add a couple more magma engines to the buildcraft power at some point. And I really need to come up with a better layout for them, I think. Right now, what I've got is it works for one line, but I'd really like to have more of an array of them. Okay, and we're pretty close to water here, so we'll just run outside and fill up these buckets. Find a spot that it will recreate the water spring at. There we go. Good, didn't glitch out on me. And this whole area still needs to be cleaned up a little bit to be more useful for what we want. I think I'm actually going to do a regular full infinite spring back here. Like so. And like so. There we go. That way I have enough water back there to rebuild this if needed. So there it's filling up with water. And it should fill up fairly quick as well. Actually, can I make this output? Does this have an output on the bottom of it? That would be good to know. Let's see, I need to go this way one and that way two. But I need to be down one more block, otherwise I'm going to end up flooding myself out. Oh, there is an output on the bottom. So what I want to do... Whoops, that's not what I wanted to do. What I want to do here is similar to the way that we have this, the maintenance level, the pipe level on the main factory area. I want to do something similar to that here. Why does that look like it's flowing? Weird. I want to do something similar where all of the pipe is underneath. And, let's see, in this case, at least some of it is going to have to be a little bit lower, but I can come back up here. And basically, we'll just run the water pipes underneath the floor at the ceiling level. And that way, wherever we need water, we can just hook up the, or bring a pipe up from underneath and connect up the water wherever we need it. Oops, that's not the right way. Just like that. There we go. And actually, maybe I want to move that, maybe I want to move this actually down as well. Something I'll have to think about. And I could even have this for the machines that are on the wall here. Like, I'm going to put the carpenter that's going to get water right on the wall here. And for the machines like that, I can just plug in right behind it. Take this over. Well, that's going to be a little bit of a problem. Let's give myself another way out here. So we just take this like so. And give this a little whack like so, and we get this connected. And I'll have to make access points to get into the underfloor area, the service level. But for now, we'll just close this off. And you can see that it's full of water, so that carpenter is all ready to go. And now another setup that we need is we're going to need a squeezer that's next to a carpenter. I hope this will work. I might have to actually use set up pipes coming off the back. But for this one, we want this carpenter to make or to have seed oil. So I'm going to put the seed in the back there. And he should be working. I might not have enough power coming out. Let's try bumping. No, that's... Oh, I know what the problem is. This. Let's set this back down to 10. And we need to give this a whack so that it's outputting power. And you can see that's going really nice and quick. Seed oil is going where? What is it doing? I don't see the seed oil. Oh, there it is. There it is. Okay, so let's open up the area behind here. And what we do here is we take more of this conduit. We switch this to output mode. And we open up the little bit more, and we make a lever. Grab some sticks. Get us a lever here. And turn that on so that it pumps all of the seed oil out of the squeezer into the carpenter. And close this back up. There we go. And now this carpenter is getting seed oil in it. And the reason we need that is we need to make impregnated casings. Which I might have to look up the recipe for. Is it logs? Ah, it's logs. So there we go. That gives us an impregnated casing, which is what we need to make apiaries. So, obviously, the seed oil, those seeds are going very, very quickly, so we're going to need to have a much better supply of seeds. The seeds that I've got right here were just taken off of our main farm. So, the next thing we need to help with that part of things... And I'm just going to let this make as many of these impregnated casings as it can. Because we will need them. So that gives us 3. And we'll let the seed oil build up. I don't know if I can... I may need to actually build a few more of these redstone energy cells. Just so that I can use them as on-off switches for different groups of machines. Because if these, I guess if the squeezer doesn't have any seeds in it, then it's not going to work. And I've got 2 storage tanks that I can fill up with seed oil, so it's probably going to be okay. The next thing that we have here is we have a squeezer. One more squeezer is going to be for squeezing honey drops. And I didn't make any centrifuges. That's the other thing I needed to make. And I think the reason I didn't make any of those is because... No, I thought I did. No, I didn't make those. I made the carpenters. So I do need to make some centrifuges still. And that's going to be a little while. So... Next, since we have our impregnated casings, I also need to make some project tables for in here, because I don't want to do all of this the hard way here. I think... Is that right? No. Let's look up the recipe for apiary. I need planks on top. Whoops. So let's make some planks. There we go. And put the casings, and let's divvy this up. And that gives us 3 apiaries to start with here. Now, we also need to get... we need to collect some bees. So these are... This squeezer's going to be keep going. We got a decent supply of seed oil built up here for anything that we need to make with seed oil. Let's go back to the main base area and pick up some wool. I do have a good bit of wool already trimmed and ready to go. So let's... I'll just run back over here. I still I definitely need to get the wireless redstone put in place for the for our thing. I'm gonna make it daytime first of all, and then I'll make a scoop over here. Let's see. And I'll get rid of a little bit of inventory while I'm over here as well. Let's see, we don't need this. We should be done with copper for a while. And I don't need these covers. So let's go ahead and make a scoop or two. We'll make two of them. These don't tend to last very long. So let's go see if we can find some suitable hives on our way back over. Whoa. How's this cell doing? Oh, halfway full. That energy cell was over at the main wheat farm. Now, I know a little bit about the bees, but I haven't done a huge amount with them. There we go. So that gave us a mossy comb, a marshy princess, and a marshy drone. I know we still need to have a get a suitable place set up for them to with the right flowers and things of that nature. And what I have in mind as far as the setup for the bees, I'd like to get some automation going for them, especially for the bees that are going to be keeping the tree breeding farm going. Let's look around for some more hives here while we talk. So yeah, definitely need an automated system for the tree farm bees. The production bees might not be quite as automated. There's a village over here. I'm sure this village has already been thoroughly ransacked. Ooh, did that get taken? I think so. I see it dug out underneath. Let's look in here. Some copper. Yeah, nothing great. I'm betting that all of the bees in this area have already been taken. But we'll take a quick look around. There's some bees. Not that I have any inventory space whatsoever here. I should have put my turtle and some of this other stuff away. I guess I can always use the sorting ender chest to stick things in the sorting system. Especially since there's a bunch of bees here. I also need this apiarist backpack at some point. But I need enough honeycombs to make that. Let's see here. What can we get rid of? We can light this area up a little bit. Might as well. Never know. Somebody might need to come over here, and having it lit up helps them out a little bit. Let's chow down a little bit here. And is there anything else I can get rid of? Let's do this. Let's make a place for a little bit of lava. There we go. And we'll get rid of that redstone just because I should put something over this little bit of lava. We'll put one of these over it. There we go. That way somebody can't just fall in it completely on accident. What is this? A Meadows Princess, we've got a Marbled Princess, and a Marbled Drone. And there's one more hive. Let's get this hive, and we'll head back, because we are full up to the brim. And a Forest Princess. So let's head back and get our apiaries set up. I'll probably end up shuffling these around a bunch of times in the process of getting everything set up and running the way I want it to. So that's what you see here right now is pretty well guaranteed is not going to be the long-term solution. See if I can find my way back without getting lost. Should be right over this hill here. There's the markings. Let's see. We'll set up these bees right here for the time being. And we'll try to get on one side of a road or another anyway. How about right here? I could also pick up the apiaries from the spawn area. I may end up doing that. I don't know for sure. We'll see. So let's see, we got a Meadows. We'll put the Marbleds in together. Kind of what I gotta do to start. He wants... What do they want? Make your bee happy. So he doesn't like it here. And I don't have enough drones here. Let's put these guys in and see if they'll work here. Because I need to at least get it started. And it looks like they are working. So those bees are going to get busy with it here. And we need to also get this one more squeezer here. Let's go ahead and... Well, actually, we need to go pick up our other bee machines and bring them over. So one more trip back through the tunnels. We'll drop off a bit of extra stuff, I think. And we need more honeycombs, so we gotta wait for bees to get working before we can make any of the apiary tools. But we need this analyzer. I've got a bee-alyzer. A bee analyzer. I've got a analyzer, which is more of a plug-in machine. And I get this bee-alyzer. And the bee-alyzer takes honey drops. This machine takes just takes liquid honey. So it'll be the preferred method once we get up and running. Let's see, what else do we want to take? Let's go ahead and get this rubber that I've been carrying around forever. Dropped off here. Drop this rubber there. I guess I'm actually going to keep my bee, or my this turtle with me, because I do need to make some more tunnels and clear out some more space, but I can get some other things out of my inventory. And the other thing that is also going to be coming up very soon, the last couple episodes, you've seen that I've been doing a lot of computer craft coding. A lot of that is just to get some practice in with some simpler code. Ooh, and it looks like Cannibal has been busy making iridium ingots out of the ferrous nuggets that we've collected and other iridium materials. But anyway, you've seen that I've been doing a lot of work on computer craft programs for the turtles. And like I said, a lot of that's to practice, to get a little bit more experience with Lua so I can start working on the big project, which is going to be the remote retrieval system for our for the storage system. It's going to take a little while to get that completely written, and I've got to make some design decisions for it. Things like, do I want to have that all hooked up into a online database, or, you know, kind of like how Good has done his, or just run it computer to computer with some sort of table that gets loaded. Haven't decided a whole lot on that yet. I also have started collecting wool for the project, because in order to make this whole machine work, I'm going to need a ton of insulated wires and bundled wires and all sorts of things like that. So it's going to take a while just to get all of the parts together. But I have a decent idea how to set up the program itself. The hardest part right now is just figuring out how to make it communicate. Why are all of these pointing the wrong way? Somebody rearranged the turtle charger and stole a power cable for it. Well, that's how it's supposed to be. I don't have any more power cables to connect it. Anyway, let's see here. Do we have everything we needed? I think so, at least for the moment. Let's go and... I think the one honey drop that I do have, I think is over there. Well, actually, you know what? While we're here, let's grab some more copper and make a couple of centrifuges. I hear slimes. The remote retrieval system will be very, very useful. Something else that I need to make, and I might do this for next episode, is a recycler and start recycling some of the stone that we've been collecting that we have just ridiculous amounts of. Let's do this. Add a couple pieces of glass, gives us a centrifuge. We'll take two of those. And head back over to the bee factory. The bee workshop. I know there's a whole bunch of advanced machines as well. I'll be getting into those for sure. Because I don't want to just have to breed and happen across a lot of the different things by chance. There's a honey drop. So definitely want to be using machines, the genetic machines, in order to find out different things about the bees. Let's see what we get from Mossy Comb. More honey and some beeswax. Beeswax, what can we do with that? Beeswax we can turn into pipe waterproof. And we can use it to make all of these different molds and capsules. And we can even use it to make torches. I don't know if it can be squeezed or anything like that. That would be handy. If you could squeeze it into liquid honey or something like that. Let's go take a look at... Our bees should be sleeping right now. I don't know if he's actually working or not. Let's stick him in. Whoops. Oh, that was weird. Let's put the Marshy Queen in here. It says Flowers Mushroom. No nasty effects. Normal, damp, one either direction. Makes mossy combs and all sorts of mutations that we can't see yet. That's cool. So I wonder, I didn't see if he was actually working or not. I may need to actually get a mushroom out here for those bees. Let's also, you can also see here I've got three Thermionic Fabricators. Those are going to come into play for, let's see, Squeezer, that's Carpenter Squeezer. Those are going to come into play in the future for some of the other machines. Let's open up behind here. That is not what I was supposed to be putting in. It was supposed to be a squeezer. There we go. He's making honey. Not very much honey. Okay, what the heck just happened? Where'd my liquiducts go? I just had 50 liquiducts vanish. That's not cool at all. How's he doing? Yeah, that's staying full. We got a good supply of seed oil out of seeds. Okay, there's the liquiducts. What? I don't know what happened there. Okay, something is broken in this area. Anyway, that worked. Okay, that's just weird. I don't know what's happening here. Weird. It's like there's something wrong with that one little spot. Okay, let's get a lever. Oh, come on. Weird things are happening here. Let's just try putting this lever over here. What the hell? I can't put a lever here, even. And my I must be, like, not really here. So, well, I wanted to show this machine, but I guess I'm not going to be able to do that right now. Anyway, I guess that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you guys are enjoying this series, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!